cannot promise you a life of sunshine. I cannot promise you riches, wealth, or gold. I cannot promise you an easy pathway that leads away from change or growing old. But I can promise all my heart's devotion, a smile to chase away your tears of sorrow, a love that's true and ever growing, a hand to hold in yours through each tomorrow.
Would you please be outstanding?
What's also made today feel very perfect is having my wonderful brother walk me down the aisle. To have my little incredibly cute and mischievous brother hold my hand today was beyond special and made me feel so very proud. Thank you, Carl.
We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Tom and Serena, to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy. Tom and Serena, you are beginning the great and wonderful adventure that is marriage. Today, we all wish you every happiness, not just for today, but for all the wonderful days ahead. May God bless you both richly in your future life together. Thomas, will you take Serena Victoria to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Serena Victoria, will you take Thomas to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
I, Thomas, take you, Serena Victoria, to be my wife.
I, Serena, take you, Thomas,
to be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
Heavenly Father, source of everlasting love, by your blessing, let these rings be to Thomas and Serena, symbols to remind them of the covenant made this day, through your grace in the love of your Son, and in the power of your Holy Spirit.
Serena Victoria, I give you this ring
as a sign of our marriage.
With my body I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have,
I share with you.
So Thomas, I give you this ring.
Thomas, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
You
get it on.
No, give it a shove.
Where am I?
That's the spirit.
Fantastic.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, Thomas and Serena have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those who God has joined together, let no one put asunder. and may I be the first to congratulate you on your wedding. Shall we give them a round of applause? My beloved speaks and says to me, "Arise, my love, my beautiful one, and come away. For behold, the winter is past, the rain is over and gone, the flowers appear on the earth, the time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree ripens its figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my beautiful one, and come away. Set me as a seal upon your heart, a seal upon your arm, for love is strong as death. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it."
First of all, a massive thank you to all of you for coming today, and also for making the effort. Most of you, apart from the Haynes family, have had to travel down. We really appreciate it, and it just feels amazing to have you all here, so thank you. It's the first time I can introduce myself as Mrs. Haynes. I think there are five Mrs. Haynes here today now, building our empire. Church Farm is exactly what Tom and I had envisioned as a dream place to get married, and the fact it actually existed was incredible in itself. But even more so, the fact that it's in Kington Langley, the village where Tom grew up, and where I've spent most of my 20s growing up, makes it more special and really personal.
After 18 months of planning, organising, and most of all worrying about the weather, which probably didn't need to, we're finally here. I hope you're all enjoying your day so far. Everybody certainly looks like they are. Feedback's been pretty good, so yeah. So first of all, our magnificent bridesmaids, Rebecca, Catherine, Jamie, and of course Isabel. You've done a wonderful job. A wonderful job today, but also just generally to Serena throughout the whole process. Helping her, advising her, arranging a wonderful hen do, I understand, for her. Certainly the picture suggested it was pretty darn good, and Serena came back raving about it. A couple of other thank yous to wedding party, my best men over there. Thank you so much to Gus and Joe. everything they've done for me in the build up to this and today. I do of course reserve the right to withdraw that thanks in about 20 minutes or so, but for the moment, thank you very much. To my mum and dad, Moira and Anna. So thank you so much for all of the assistance, support, ideas, contributions, and time in respect of everything that you've done for us. We have highly valued your input and assistance over the last 18 months. And of course, everything that you've done for the both of us in the last 8 years or so, and for me, of course, in the last 34 years. I couldn't ask for better parents, even though I regularly asked to exchange you as a child. So thank you, Mum and Dad. Before we get stuck in, I want to say to Serena and Tom, like, this venue and your wedding is absolutely immense. It's an incredible experience, and I know we're all gonna have one heck of a party later. And Serena, now I know I'm not gonna be the only one to say this to you today, but you look absolutely stunning. You really are a gorgeous bride. If ever there was a moment that, Tom, you realized that you're punching well above your weight, today is the day. Tom and I met at some stage during the 80s. And we really hit it off right from the start. Growing up, we did everything together. Some of my favorite memories with Tom are things that brothers do, like trying to make sure that we finish off our first sticker album, which we obviously never completed because nobody ever does. Playing cricket in the garden in Mum and Dad's house all summer. Also trying to start our band, the Wildcats, which never took off. But it's still time. I just want to say, Tom, that I love growing up with you. We have had so many good memories, and you've been a great brother to me, and now friend. And Mum told me to say all that. Four,
two, one.
Chop it! I'm Gus, Tom's brother from another mother. I think it's important to mention today that Tom has not always been quite the English gent that he would have us all to believe. There is a period before Tom became an aristocrat that Joe and I like to call the gold chain years. I think a lot of us can all remember that, yeah. Tom very quickly went from skinhead to side parting. The pint of lager became a very dirty dry martini, and his taste of women became wholly concerned with which political party they supported. So, I want to take a moment to say that being asked to be your best man has been one of the great honours in my life. Thank you. You're the best friend any guy could ask for, and I sincerely hope that both you and Serena have the most wonderful, happy life together.
Being the younger brother has given me the luxury of watching somebody go first in life. And today, more than any other day in this situation, you've shown your character the best by marrying the beautiful Serena, who is your wife. Serena, I'm so proud to call you my sister today. Today, oh, they hear me, that one. You're both creating an amazing story for yourself. And remember, this is just the beginning. So I think we'd all like to raise a toast to the to the bride and groom.
Yeah. Bride and groom. Okay. Are we done here?
Yeah.
There's standing ovation.
I want to thank you, Tom, for always being by my side no matter what, making me laugh, feel safe, and for always understanding, even at times when it's pretty difficult to understand me. Before all I heard was silence. Thank goodness I took the last minute decision to go out and bath that night. I had no idea I was going to meet the man of my dreams. I have to say, I also never envisioned meeting my future husband in the Rat and Parrot, for those of you who know it. I could not be happier to be your wife, and I can't wait to see what the next chapter brings. Now I can find the key without you, and now your song is on repeat, and I'm dancing on to your heartbeat.
one person that I would like to thank, and that's my darling wife. Thank you for being you. You make me so happy, Serena, and make me a better person. You're kind, caring and thoughtful, loving and loyal. You're strong-willed and independent, but you also have a softer side which I can't help but adore. I'm so glad we met on that Christmas Works night out and we've never looked back since. You're amazing, incredible, I know this is a lot of adjectives, but amazing, incredible, beautiful. I've written them down, so I've got to read them. I'm so lucky that you agreed to spend the rest of your life with me, and I promise to ensure that you don't spend a single day regretting it. You are truly my kindred spirit, and as keen yogis, the yin to my yang.
I've never been one of those little girls who had pictured the perfect wedding day. What I always did picture, though, was having my mum there. Although she's missed and isn't physically here, I know she's present in each and every one of you that knew her, and you all did bring a different side of her here today. In memory of mum this evening, we'll be dedicating our first dance to her. The song we have chosen is also really special to me. Every Sunday between the ages of 16 and 18, Mum would drive me back to school for the week, and we'd listen to the same album, singing our hearts out. So please join us this evening, and dance if you feel like it, to celebrate both our special day and my wonderful mum.
Now is the most too late for me to take a step.